coming day with a smile. Berliners, face the coming day with a smile. Berliners, face the coming day with a smile. Or face it with a frown, if you must. But let's face it, time to get up. Berliners, face the coming day with a smile. Or face it with a frown, if you must. But let's face it, time to get up. We early birds who love life, we are up at the crack of dawn, aren't we? Why waste time, best of all possible birds, dreaming in our beds, right? Not when the day brings new adventures, new faces, new intrigues. Why waste time, at the best of all possible birds, dreaming in our beds, right? Not when the day brings new adventures, new faces, new intrigues. Come on, up and moving. Two more stretches, another sit up. Get your coffee on. Only 2 minutes to six. Your life is flying by. Only 2 minutes to six. Your life is flying by. Only 2 minutes to six. Your life is flying by.
So much to do, so much to do, so much to do, to do. Where can you find the time? Club Dorados. The time of your life. Club Dorados. Take your time. Club Dorados. Club Dorados. Escape. Escape to a better life. Dorados. Time to go. Time to go. Time to go.
Not suicide, is it? Surviving witnesses are saying it wasn't an accident. Was it sabotage?
Get him out of my way.
The public has a right to know.
The public will know when we know.
I'm with Marta Media. Don't push me around.
I don't care. With your mother.
Shh.
suicide?
Can't tell. Yeah, I can think of better ways to start the day. Oh.
All that the rescue teams can do is to evacuate the neighboring residents on both sides of the wall. But they're powerless to control the spread of the toxic fumes. According to Commissioner of Police Kessler, it's still too early to say positively if this was a suicide attack. But if it was, it's the third attack causing massive loss of human life after the propane spill in East Berlin and the contamination of the water supply in the Merkischviertel housing complex. But accident or suicide, today's disaster is even more horrific than the others. First estimates put the death toll at over 400. All that the rescue teams can do is to evacuate the neighboring residents on both sides of the wall. But they're powerless to control the spread of the toxic fumes. According to Commissioner of Police Kessler, it's still too early to say positively if this was a suicide attack.
But I'm at the wall, it's hellish. You can smell the fear of suicide. Kessler's out of his depth. There's a meeting of both mayors, east and west, on this very day. Even Bonn is sending someone. What they'll come up with, God only knows.
Trained in the Middle East. They must be.
In the West, you mean? It's obvious.
Gentlemen, please. We've had incidents on both sides, and now at the war itself. Let's forget the bloody ideology and let Commissioner Kessler proceed with his report.
The death toll will continue to mount at the hospitals, so it is still too early to estimate precisely. But 500, maybe a conservative figure?
Another boat pile.
These accidents happen.
They're not accidents, they're suicides. We don't know that yet.
What do you want them to do? Leave notes? Goodbye, cruel world?
This sort of callousness is uncalled for.
I'm not callous, Mr. Mayor. I'm realistic.
Lieutenant Hartmann, we don't need rumor mongering. There is no use creating a general panic.
Yeah, not when it's being done for us.
Our job is to contain the situation. Not to indulge in wild speculation.
Exactly.
Oh, yes, I had this funny idea. Our job was to find out what's behind these accidents.
Which is precisely why I'm putting Captain Engler in charge of the investigation.
Do you have anything to support your theory about these so-called suicides, Lieutenant?
Common sense.
Then you can tell us why these people are killing themselves.
You'll have to ask the dead, Captain Engler. The only one who understands a suicide is another suicide.
The way you understood the death of your wife?
Suicides are not, gentlemen. The result is the same.
But if people begin to believe this nonsense about a... what are they calling it? A suicide virus? Then that's got to be avoided at all costs. I'm telling you, the mood in the city is one of...
Calm. In the West, at least. Calm prevails. Berliners are sophisticated. We've seen worse.
In the East, yes, people are worried. But then, on our side of the wall, we don't have the highest suicide rate in Germany.
Europe! Herr Bürgermeister. Europe. At the rate we're going, Berlin, we can say, for voluntary deaths, is second to none. And if your lieutenant is right, this new hobby is one that Marta Media will have to report.
Doctor,
We only want you to report the truth. As always.
I believe you know everybody. This is Herr Penck, director of East Berlin Security. Dr. Marsfeld.
President of Mater Media, of course. But
most of you are understandably worried about public opinion. I thought you might be interested to see this. Berliners, it seems, are suddenly rather anxious to go on vacation. This is an hour ago at the office of the holiday club of Ceratus on Kurfürstendamm.
What's happening? Good morning.
I can get you four.
Just a minute. I may have some.
Starting this weekend?
Yeah, I have two questions.
I take it.
If it's a conspiracy, perhaps we should be investigating all the vacation clubs and travel agents. Shall we? It won't be so funny if it starts to spread outside Berlin.
Let's not make it sound like a disease.
Whatever it is. If it's infectious.
Gloves. Gloves. I want to apologize for Engler's reference to Nina. It was uncalled for.
Yes.
Klaus, please. He's a good man, but he gets carried away.
God save us from good men who get carried away. You tell your good Captain Engler, he doesn't fuck with me, I won't fuck with him.
Lieutenant Hartmann, would you mind?
Lieutenant Hartmann. Herr Penck and I were intrigued by your suspicion of suicides. We know there have been several in the past few weeks, but it's unlikely they'd be related to these attacks and public disasters.
I didn't say they were. All I said was they weren't accidents.
You mean a common motivation? But suicide, apart from mass hysteria...
I'm a cop, Colonel Penck. I don't know about hysteria or diseases. I just see people dying and taking a lot of their neighbors with them.
One after the other. From a car, a window, a bridge. In a city like ours, there's no lack of diving boards, is there? If you do get anything on the suicide angle, you keep me informed?
No doubt you'll hear about it.
Much to do, to do. Where can you find the time? Club Doratos. The time of your life. Take your time. Club Doratos. Time to unwind, relax, renew. Doratos. Drifto. Let yourself go. Leave it all behind. Toronto's. Escape.
From the sixth floor.
Escape to a better life. Toronto's. Time to go. Time to go. Time to go.
Must originate here in the West. The more they insist these deaths are accidents, the more certain I am. You'll have to keep an eye on this Lieutenant Hartmann and Marsfeld. Why should he be so interested?
Death is always newsworthy.
is not to be trusted. No one that powerful.
Speaking of trust, can one be assured that this isn't coming from one's own security service?
Mozart.
Yes.
Don't make jokes in bad taste. I begin to wonder if you can be trusted. I'll be away for a week. Communicate with no one else.
Location?
Corsica. Or Corfu. I don't know. My wife arranged it, one of these Terratos clerks.
One can only hope you come back arrested.
Because he brought wit and panache to the airwaves over Berlin, didn't he? On both sides of the wall, he'll be sorely missed. We used to say, wake up with fight, go to bed with Geldern. But without Reimer, we no longer heard fight und bright around Berlin. On to happier news. TV East One is pleased to announce that our show, The Good Life, will be adding a late evening offering, The Late Life, beginning next week.
Who is it?
It's me.
Klaus, you go. She's a definite. If I see the leftovers of another life...
Go on. I'll be down in a minute.
A lot of self-portraits, Frau Sednik.
That's my business.
Yeah, I guess it would be. If Anna Sednik hadn't taken her swan dive in the Westkreuz station yesterday.
She's dead?
I didn't hear about the woman who threw herself under the train. Please.
You modeled for her?
No. I never even heard of her before today. She sent me her key. And she sent me this.
Why you?
I don't know. People are always sending me things.
Oh, yes, I know who you are. The time to go, girl, on the tip of everyone's tongue. Including Anna Sidnick's.
You make me sound like a postage stamp.
A stamp has a purpose.
May I go now?
Did you touch anything here? Fine.
No. Why did she kill herself?
She forgot to say. Sonia Fogler, if you get any more fan mail from the dead, let me know, okay? I'm Lieutenant Hartmann.
Anything?
I want forensic to cover every millimeter. They always leave something. Take a look at this.
You know, a lot of people are saying it's the millennium. With 2000 coming up, it's the end of the world. And the smart ones are getting out now. While they have a choice. I mean, it's a crackpot idea, but people are crackpots. And there has to be a reason. People need reasons. You don't kill yourself for nothing.
What was the truck driver's name?
Zer, Martin Zer, at Albertstrasse 3.
Any family?
Wife. Two kids.
Time of your life. Club Dorados. Take your time. Club Dorados.
You tell them that we don't want their sickness here. Spill your filthy blood in someone else's neighborhood.
That's enough. Show some respect. Go away.
Vorseher, Lieutenant Hartmann, Police, this is Sergeant Stieglitz. If you feel up to it, I thought there might be something you'd like us to know about your husband. He didn't leave anything?
Yes, a family. Two girls.
No, I mean a letter or picture, something. And
why should he leave a note? He didn't kill himself. Martin was a family man. He loved his girls. He was happy. He'd hurry home after work to be with them. He just took us all on vacation. He's a good father. I don't care what the newspapers say. They are lies. He'd never kill himself. Never. It's a crime against God. It was an accident. I'm sorry about what happened to all those people. But something was wrong with the truck. It was an accident.
Are you friends with my papa?
In a way, yes.
Are you sick too?
Klein, Roger, Rudi, Zer, Martin, locker 22. Here we are, Martin Zer's locker. There it is.
Close. Close.
The unfortunate Reimer from Gelder. How very surprising.
Of course. He already had water in the lungs, but not much smoke to speak of. He was already dead. 500 milligrams will generally get you pretty fast.
Good morning.
Dr. Marston. How wonderful to see you.
No, I don't want any special treatment.
God knows, I suppose I need it. I'm not exactly a television personality. No, I only want to say a few words. I'm sure all you talented people will stop me from looking too foolish. Oh, yes. Yes, I brought with me some associates. Akim.
Sometimes I think I'd rather be in the morgue. They've got it easy. They only have to deal with the dead. It's the ones left behind that get me. Poor woman. Leaving them all alone like that. If I had a wife and kids and that happened to me, I don't know what I'd do.
You wouldn't do anything. You'd be dead.
You know what I mean. Where is your sympathy? You saw her with the kids? If you had a family, maybe you'd know what I'm talking about. Oh, I'm sorry, Klaus. I'm sorry. Oh, shit. I don't know what's got into me. I mean, I just got back from vacation and I feel like I need another. It's this fucking Elsa. It's like God's playing Russian roulette. Anyone could be next. Her? Her? Him? It must be worse for you with what happened to Nina.
She had nothing to do with this. Nina wasn't part of that.
No, I know, but...
It was 2 years ago.
I know. I was not saying she was.
She had other reasons.
We all know what she was going through.
No, we don't. Not really. Well, the doctor came out with that... when it was too late. Much too late. He said, your wife, Nina, was pregnant. Nina hadn't told me. All I know is death beat me once, took away half of my life. I'll never get back.
But half a life is better than none.
So much to do. Where can you find the time? Drift off.
Not all dead.
Let all yourself dead. Go.
Stiglitz, pull yourself together.
Leave it all dead. Behind. Tarotus. Escape. Escape to a better life. Tarotus. Time to go.
All dead.
Time to
all
go.
Dead, okay?
Of your service.
Proceed, Dr. Marston.
Amosa, DDRTV News.
Do you have an appointment?
Naturally.
Would you be seated, please, Herr Mauser?
Mauser.
Herr Mauser? Dr. Marsfeld is otherwise engaged and finds it impossible to keep his appointment. He begs that you accept his apologies and supposes he will have the pleasure to meet with you in the nearest of futures. Thank you.
Please convey to the doctor that the pleasure will not be all his in the nearest of futures.
No touching. Stay back. No
all
touching.
Right. Don't be afraid. Touching doesn't bother me.
Leave us
alone. Signora,
are you mad? What if they're infected? Thank you. That's all. Thank you very
Tarotus.
Much.
Tarotus.
Sonia must be going. No
drift
more
on. Let yourself
go.
Go.
Time to go. Time to go.
Leave it all behind.
What was that? Your idea of a joke? Rather unhealthy sense of humor. You're not one of them anymore, remember?
If I'm not one of them, then who am I one of? Time to go. Time to go.
Do you know where I found this? In the truck driver's locker who crashed into the train the other day. Does this remind you of anything? What are you to these people? The angel of death?
That's not me. That's a face. It's not mine. I can't control it. What do you think, that I killed them?
No. They killed themselves. Why, I don't know. I don't think they did either.
Well, don't look at me. I don't know. Maybe they're sick. People say it's a virus.
Maybe. Maybe they're lovesick.
Should I be laughing at that?
Two people kill themselves at the same time. They both had pictures of you, pictures defaced in the same way. That suggests a connection, doesn't it? Don't tell me it's because you're on every video board in the whole city.
Well, what do you think, that I had affairs with them all? And the woman, too? Watch out, I'm the Black Widow.
Sleep either. Can
you? Sleep isn't the problem. The only thing that comes to a sleeper is a dream. It's the waking. Excuse me.
Hello. Oh, forgive me for delaying your normal entertainment, but the children asked me, please, could they do something nice for their friend and guardian? Herr von Gelden.
How could I do this? As much as these children love
you. Oh, I'm terribly sorry. I thought I was afraid.
Moisturizer. You want to try some?
No.
Maybe you like this better.
Micro-targeted cellular analog replenisher. Jesus Christ.
Well, if you haven't tried it, don't knock it.
I polish my shoes, not my face.
Well, you make your living with your feet, don't you? My face has made me a lot of money. I take care of it. It takes care of me.
Of course, when your face is your life...
It's not my life, it's my living. And don't confuse this with who I am.
I don't. But then again, it doesn't make me want to kill myself.
Reimer von Gelden was more than just the host of Germany's most popular talk show.
What you said was uncalled for.
Yeah, I hope so.
These children love him more.
Look, I'm paid to send people on vacation, not to their graves. Now I wish you would leave me in peace.
And thanks to your help.
One more question. You've never met any of these people before?
Him, yes.
Unlike so many of us these days, Reimer knew that between The head that thinks.
Marsfeld?
Von Gelten.
You didn't get something from him?
No. Why should I? Besides, we hardly even knew each other. We met at parties, modern media events, you know, the usual way.
Yeah, one celebrity to another.
Yes, that's right, superficially.
I don't give a fuck if you lead a superficial life or not. As far as I can see, neither do you. It's the people who stop leading their lives.
That you give a fuck about.
I know the rumors flying about Berlin, the ugly lies.
You see the news today? An ambulance driver, a guy supposed to save lives, he drives into a store window. He kills three people. It's not superficial, Sonja Vogler! What's it got to do with you? If Berliners decide to meet their maker a little early. Tell me.
As much as... But these rumors are false.
Here's what he was looking at when he crashed.
And thanks to your help. I mean, how
is there anything that might connect you to these people?
So full of love. How could he?
I think.
Yeah.
I think that.
For the sake of the children. No. A tragic accident and no more. We can be sure of that, can't we?
What the hell is he talking about?
Rhino, the angels.
There are no rumors about suicide. If you think of anything, get in touch with me.
No one's safe. Not Reimer, can't be. They're scared to death. What do we tell them?
You'll be hearing from them again. For they are Reimer von Gelden's true legacy.
You are not pale enough for a corpse.
That's because I was having such a beautiful dream, Lieutenant.
What's the word? Voluptuous. Such a voluptuous young lady. Just like one we had here the other day.
At least you can't go back to your dreams. The others?
Oh, the others. They dream of funerals.
Any suicides?
Suicides? Any that aren't. A very popular way of getting a ticket to the morgue. Yeah.
What about Reimer von Gelden?
Well, Reimer, oh, he's still here. He leaves tomorrow. Would you like to see him?
No, but he didn't do himself in, did he?
Between you, me, and him.
Yeah.
He took a very, what's the word? Efficacious. A very efficacious painkiller. Cyanide.
Do we still have the personal effects?
Personal effects?
About the youth of today, the way they throw their lives away.
In my day, we used to flirt with girls, and now they flirt with oblivion.
Disposable.
What?
Disposable.
The ultimate consumer product. When they've used themselves up, they throw the lads away. Dr. Marsfeld, would you agree to an interview for East German TV?
I never appear on the media, save in the most extraordinary of circumstances.
Aren't these extraordinary circumstances? The suicides plaguing the city.
If they are suicides, but not for me to pronounce upon. I transmit the news, I never make it. A wise policy, I found.
Yes. But Club Terratus.
Terratus? Terratus. Oh, yes, that vacation club. What of it?
You own it.
Do I?
A subsidiary of Marta Media.
if subsidiaries were children. I'm afraid the state would find me an unfit mother.
Suggestion. A story on Club Terratus. Now that so many people need to get away from Berlin for a while, the idea is to go to one of the resorts, do a report from there. How people get Berlin out of their systems.
From what I know of these clubs, they're overrun with vacationers. Understandably. I would hesitate to disturb the peace of a man on vacation, especially a harried Berliner. Let them escape in peace. Don't you agree? When this madness has passed, when the man in the street will not be chagrined to find reminders of Berlin in paradise. Don't you agree? A pleasure, Herr Mauser.
Mauser.
Mauser. A palpable pleasure. Kathy, won't you take her Mother in hand, show him something of extinction? You'll find it
perfect.
Thank you.
That's it. Rouge and Peripas.
What is it, my dear?
He sent it to me before he killed himself.
Who?
Reimer von Geldern. And so did that woman who threw herself under the train.
Defaced. Oh, macabre.
I didn't even know her. Or the man who was driving the truck. Am I going to get something from every suicide in Berlin? Why do they choose me? Why don't they leave notes for their friends or their wives or anybody, but why me? Why me? Is it my face? Is it the club?
The club?
Terratus. They all went to Terratus. I know Reimer did.
And so did this anisednik, I'm sure of it. They're not killing themselves because of me, are they?
No.
They can't. They have no right. I don't want them to.
No. Sonia, no. Sonia, I'll tell you what it is. These pathetic, tortured people. Who can know how anyone is driven to such a despairing act? But in our darkest hour, when we look death in the face, we grasp out for something living, something vital. And that's what you are for those people. Something in them reaches out for what's good and lovely. You, Sonia. For all of us in Berlin, you're what is best and most beautiful about life. I dislike to see you so unhappy. It's not flattering. Such an exquisite creature.
I want my face back. I don't want to be on the video boards anymore, and I don't want to be in magazines or on TV. I want it back. Toronto's can use someone else.
Sonia, how can we do that? People would be so disappointed.
I don't care about people. They can kill themselves over someone else.
I'd be disappointed. And there is your contract.
You said I could get out any time. It's a formality, you said. Between us, there could never be a contract, only friendship. That's what you said.
Admirable, aren't they? The way they throw themselves on the mercy of luck. Show us the probability of winning. One in God knows what. Are we deterred? Never. I'm not a statistic. I'm not a number. You won't catch me in that net. There's always a chance. And yet we don't like to think of our lives as random either. There is a purpose. And that purpose is to behave as though we can escape our fate.
No talent of my own. I transmit, that's all. The news, other people's ideas, other personalities. I'm insubstantial, a medium in a medium. My ratings are dropping. I know they won't fight. I was above 35% 11 straight years. No one's ever come close to that long. But what does Metamedia care? Well, fuck you, Marsfeld, and all the rest of you pocket calculators. I try something not on the program. You kick and scream. Well, you won't find this on the program. End of broadcast. Reimer von Gelden goes off the air. Time to escape. How do you put it? To a better life, Sonia?
This too morbid a question for 7 in the morning. Do we want suicide with our coffee and roll? We do not. But thanks to Reimer, we shall have to put up with a little moral indigestion. Can we pretend a sickness doesn't exist? Maybe if we bury our heads in the sports pages, in the fashion pages, we want to be infected. We all want to go on living. Certainly, I couldn't have the disease. But that's always the way, isn't it? No one believes it's an epidemic until he, too, is running a temperature.
You work for Metamedia.
Well, I get paid anyway. We don't do much work. He just likes to have us around.
And why is that?
It's obvious, can't you tell? Because we are all so exquisite. He's a connoisseur. He hardly even notices us, but if you're not there... Oh, I almost forgot. Every time you use the card, to open the door, it's recorded. So you better be careful.
One had always better be careful. And one.
I think you can expect a visit. He persuaded me to give him the card.
I suggest nullification.
No.
I can have it done tonight, discreetly. She's a weakness. There's no alternative.
No. She's not a candidate. Do not nullify. Do not nullify.
We ran the background on Sonia Vogler. She's an orphan. No record of her parents or where she came from.
Her sponsor is Dr. Marsfeld.
Yes, I looked into that. He actually adopted her.
Relax. Renew.
See you tomorrow.
Toratos. Drift off. Escape. Let yourself go.
Hey, Klaus.
Leave it all behind.
All style. No substance.
That's what dreams are made of.
Toratos.
So you know what she looks like. And a suicide, of course. The method of departure I leave up to you.
Thank you, sir.
You're safe, you're safe, you're safe. It's okay. You better wait a sec, though. He might come back, huh? You okay?
Yeah.
You want a cigarette?
No.
Okay. I know you. Don't I?
I don't think so.
Try out this girl. Huh?
I think he's gone now. I think I should go.
Time to go. Time to go. Say it. Please. No. Say it for us. Say it for me. Please say it. Time to go.
Not the best playmate for a game of hide and seek.
I just want you to know that I'm not like them. I want to live.
Are you sure? If you like life so much, why don't you help me? Tell me what you know about Marsfeld.
I hardly know him.
No? He's your adoptive father.
I said I hardly know him. And he's not my adoptive father. Oh.
Who do you think you're protecting?
Myself.
George, you're filthy. Him somewhere else.
Bagman, please, clear side. Come on, come on.
We do for your sickness here.
That's enough. He's dead.
Of course he's dead. He killed please. Himself like all the others.
Come on,
are you going to protect us or arrest innocent citizens? Or are you diseased too?
He's one of ours. Better call the commissioner.
Klaus, I know how you feel.
Commissioner, would you do me a favor? No platitudes, all right? Save them for the press.
We found this in one of his boxes.
I'll take it. I'll take it. I see. Still, you sit and write this. No, he didn't write this and he didn't kill himself. He killed himself, yes, but he didn't do it.
Lieutenant.
Something else did.
Lieutenant, you're upset?
No, I'm not upset, goddammit. Stieglitz could not have killed himself.
If he's depressed enough, anyone can kill himself.
No, not anyone. That's the point. That's what's wrong with these suicides. They didn't want to kill themselves. My God, if you can see that. These are not spontaneous acts. They're linked somehow. They're linked. Did they find a picture of Sonia here? No? Well, there must be a picture of her. Somewhere.
Lieutenant Hartman! Lieutenant! I want you to go home. You're overworked. You're overstrained. I'm relieving you of your duties in this investigation.
Are you out of your mind?
I don't think I'm the one that question should be directed to.
have you kept away from Fraulein Vogler?
Yes, of course. But Hartmann seems to be after her.
Hartmann?
Intimately, I'm informed.
Thank you. Thank you. Intimately.
Sonia?
What?
What kind of smile is that for Tyratos? We want people to escape.
They already are. Nice long permanent vacations.
Yes, well, we'd rather they escape temporarily with us. They see you looking like that, they will kill themselves. This came for you yesterday. Now, dazzling. Alluring.
Alluring? Are you sure you don't want captivating? Or irresistible? Or maybe a combination? I'm smiling! Isn't that what you wanted? A big smile?
Stieglitz. Why didn't you tell me before?
I don't know. Maybe I was afraid. I didn't trust you.
Now you do.
Do you trust me? How do you know? Your friend, how do you know that he didn't want to kill himself?
Because I know. He would have left a note, something.
But he did.
No, he did not. First, it was typed. No recognizable handwriting. Second, it said, Dear Hartmann. Stieglitz never called me Hartmann. The same kind of turtle design was found on Reimer von Geldern.
Yes, I knew he'd gone to Tyratos.
Tyratos?
It's their logo, their symbol. Something to do with the pace of life, I guess. It's on the club card they give to all their vacationers. When I advertise, escape to a better life.
Oh.
No.
Please. Please. Thank you, Fräulein.
No!
You were dreaming?
No. No, I wasn't.
Thank you.
It's been so long. I lost someone.
Louis lost too. Time to go. Time to go. Where can you find the time? Club Dorados. The time of your life. Club Dorados. Take your time. Club Dorados.
We must remain calm. There is absolutely no reason to panic. Commissioner Kessler assures me that the police have everything under control and are working quickly and efficiently to trace the cause of these unfortunate accidents. I appeal to you as Berliners, fellow Berliners. This is not the time to abandon your city.
Kathy!
Oh, it does my heart good to see you. The demise of these poor children.
Death and beauty. They are our only true refuges in life. Our only perfection. What brings you out on this dark day?
I've decided that I need a vacation.
Do you?
I'm afraid I nearly had a breakdown yesterday during a shoot, and I thought that a week somewhere might...
With someone special?
No. Alone, just to rest.
I've often wondered why you've never formed any attachments. My dear, I hope you feel I'm more than just a guardian. I would do anything I could for you. If only you'd ask.
A vacation. Just the thing. I'm sure it will solve many problems.
And what better recommendation could Club Terrazas have? Their own Sonia Vogler getting away from it all.
Oh, come back to us soon.
I will.
please reserve a vacation for Miss Vogler? For two. A one-way ticket will suffice for her companion.
Welcome to Doradus. And now, if you'll give me your watches. We don't need them here. At Dorados, nothing keeps the time.
Ah.
'Cause there is none. No past, no future, just the present. Thank you.
You'll wear this always. With your tortoise, you'll want for nothing. Mm. We have no money, no clothes. No ties to our outside selves.
No clothes. I like that.
Good. That's the sound we like to hear. We'll give you garments. We ask you to put aside everything you bring with you. No makeup, no cameras, no newspapers, no radios. In exchange, we'll give you peace.
How can I say no?
I'll show you to your bungalow and you can change. Yeah. No baggage.
Oh, yes, of course. Are you ready?
Sonia's going to her own bungalow. You'll need your own room to repose. The clothes are simple, I know. But you'll find within a day or two you won't care about fashion. Uh-huh. Your bungalow has one mirror. We encourage each vacationer to look at himself once a day to notice the change. The mirror is your other self, your Dorados self.
Oh, that's interesting.
You try to leave yourself behind and become that purer, calmer, more peaceful one. The one that only you can see.
The weather on the other side of the wall.
Threatening rain. Where is Pink?
Dead. He and his wife, their car crashed on the way back from vacation.
Suicide.
Says they're an accident. Anything to report?
Yes, as a matter of fact. The most crowded neighborhood in West Berlin is the mall.
Makeup. Okay. Keep camera one tight.
Five, four, three, two, one.
Good evening, Berlin, and welcome once again to The Late Life. Today, according to the police, 43 people took their own lives. Ah, you might say, down from yesterday. Not so bad. Those of us diehards still left in the city are getting used to death. Experts have even begun to forecast trends, like the weather. Yes, Ute, right at the moment it's looking like partial sunshine tomorrow. With patches of suicide.
And of course we have our jokes. Look on the bright side. They could be taking other people's lives. Or take my life, please. The only thing that goes around faster than a virus is death. So you might say laughing in the face of death, always a healthy sign.
But tonight we are going to stop joking. Tonight, we are going to address a question, a very natural question, one we've all thought about, but we are too afraid to ask. Is humankind doomed to extinction?
Well, let's not hold our breath about it. The answer has to be yes. The human race will disappear. The question, rather, is, what's the rush?
Set up a meeting with the good Herr Light.
Yes, sir.
please don't tell on us.
Our existence is a precarious algorithm. Neither positive nor negative. Think of yourself rather as the root of negative one. An amphibia between being and non-being. Nothing but light. Open yourself to that light. Float into it. The light is your father. Your father's Sonia. Your father's come back for you. He's missed you. You're his only child and he wants you back. And you want to go back too, don't you, Sonia? Open yourself to the light. Float into it. Let your will drain from your body. Your body drain from your soul. Accept! Accept! Accept!
You can't let go. There's too much self-hatred. Yes, you're clinging to your self-hatred. It's your most prized possession. Until you let it go, you'll always be an orphan.
Accept, 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 accept what?
Accept yourself? Ah, in exchange for what?
For nothing? That what you wanted, Nina? Nothing? Should I try and understand? Is that what you wanted? No! I don't accept!
In Berlin, everyone's taking swan dives, and here they want to float in the fucking light! Is there life before death?
Tell me, Nina. Where Nina Hartmann, inquiring minds where, want to know.
Herr Weidt.
A pleasure.
I'm a very big fan.
Oh, well, we try to do our best.
Naturally. Herr Weidt, we must do something about this madness. Someone's got to take a stand.
Oh, yes. By all means.
Oh, my dear friend.
I've always been afraid. Maybe that's why I joined the force, to show myself I was not. But I am afraid. I want to quit. But I can't. What would Klaus say? He'd say I'm so weak. I'm a coward.
I want to escape. I want to escape. I want to go home. Escape to a better life.
Nina, the doctor, much too late. Half a life is better than none.
Don't go. I don't want to lose you.
Sonia, you have to live. Do you hear me? You have to live. I lost one, I won't lose another. I won't let you go. Thank you for stopping. My wife, Sil, could you help us? I mean, could you do something for us?
Hopping.
Thank you.
You're getting out too?
Yeah, we're getting out.
They're crazy back there.
They won't let us sleep together.
They said the Eros principle negated the Thanatos principle.
If you can't screw on vacation, when can you screw?
Speak to Lieutenant Hartman, please.
Yes, of course. Wait a minute.
Yes? Herr Lang, how can I help you? Tell me, is it possible to see Lieutenant Hartman?
Lieutenant Hartman is no longer assigned to this investigation. Perhaps I can be of service. You have any information on the accidents?
No. But who does?
Terrata's Culmination, 8 p.m. Mater Media, 123. DDR TV, November 17.
I have a report from Lip. Hartmann and Sonia Vogler have escaped. Apparently they're on a plane due tonight, but they can't possibly get to East Berlin in time to stop the final broadcast. All preparations are in place, with the usual safeguards.
Good.
Poor Veit will have a sudden drop in his ratings tonight. That's the Census Bureau's job will be considerably simplified.
Yes? How so?
Who's this?
Dr. Marsfeld.
Who is this? Verify, please. Verify. Verify, please.
Verify. Verify, please.
Broadcasts. 8 o'clock, DDR studio. No time, my car. Marsfield. Killing them.
No, not Marsfield, it can't be.
Terrasas. No time.
Good evening, Berlin. This is Egon Veit with a special primetime edition of The Good Life. Let me begin by thanking Martin Media's own Dr. Heinrich Marsfeld for suggesting tonight's theme and so kindly making all of his networks available to us.
Does life weigh so heavily on us that we have to fill ourselves with the helium of death? Other cities aren't rushing into oblivion. Then again, they don't live like ours, do they? An existence defined by the idea of escape. They never had a wall.
Divided city, divided soul. Everywhere we go, a wall, a wall, a wall.
We can't get through, can we? Not to anyone. And we ask ourselves as we rush along the sidewalk, the street, the underground. All of us in the isolation tanks we call our lives. We ask ourselves. Is anybody out there? Is anybody home? The question's like a ringing phone. It rings and it rings and it rings until you snatch it up just to have some peace from that awful ringing in your head. And you shout, hello, hello. Is anybody home? Is anyone there? Just a moment, I'll check. Can you hold? And you think, yes, I'll hold. And you hold and you hold. But no one comes on your line.
All you hear is the faint roar of the electronic ocean while you wait alone in a room holding the phone. It's then the thought occurs, I'd like to hang up. Why hold? Why go on?
I could be here forever like this, holding and waiting. And for what? I'm going to hang up. Yes, I am. I'm going to hang up. Why not? It's so easy.
And then your wife or your husband, or more likely some stranger, finds you hanging from a rope or splattered on the pavement
or floating in the river, seduced by them. Seduced, but never abandoned.
But so what?
A life like this one is better off not being lived.
And now you are happy
because you are...
Take it off the air.
You are at peace because you are not at war.
Take this off the air! Hartman!
Not incarcerated.
Attempting to interfere with the state broadcast. Very grave offense.
Sonia?
There's only one way to cure the state.
Tear down the walls.
Stop the need to escape. Tear down all the walls.
Sonia!
Get out of the chair! Get out of the chair!
So much to do. So much to do.
Send me out live!
So much to do.
Switch it!
Club Gerardos. Club Gerardos. Gerardos. Escape. Escape to a better life. Gerardos. Escape. Escape to a better life. Gerardos.
Switch it!
Switch it!
Okay, go!
No! It is time to come home.
There is no escape, only life. No more vacations. The only holiday is life. No more escape. No more death. No more extinction.
The only holiday is life. No more escape. No more death. No more extinction.
It is time to come home. Home from vacation. Home to life. Home to the next day. No more extinction. It is time to come home. Home from vacation. Home to life. Life, it is a good thing. It is a precious thing.
To be protected. To be protected. To be protected.
I knew you'd come back to me. What did you think you would spare them?
Why me? My face, my voice. Is that what you wanted for me in life? Was that my purpose? To send thousands of people to their deaths?
I sent them, not you.
Did I cheat anybody? Did I send them anywhere they didn't already want to go? No. I'm a travel agent. Nothing more. I sold the ticket. They were born to buy. The trouble with life, you see, is that it's got to be lived. And they lived it and they lived it until all they wanted to do was, as we say, get away from it all. They longed to die. To put a do not disturb notice on their doors forever. We all do. It makes us human. Every morning in our beds, we say to ourselves, I'll get up. I'll go on. When our most fervent wish is not to. I grant them that wish. I send them on holiday. You were the medium, nothing more. We're drawn to only two things in life, my dear. Beauty and death. Our two perfectible states. Unfair as it may seem, people look at you and they want to believe. They think, oh, so beautiful. It must be true. They're charmed, you see. They can't help it. They find you irresistible. Just like death. So charming. You do care for me, don't you?
You must!
Wrong, Doctor. Don't like looking death in the eye, Dr. M. What about Stieglitz? The others? Now you know how they felt.
I've always known. They felt relieved! Go ahead, Lieutenant.
I've been married to life support too long.
Grant me my divorce.
No, Clubby's dying.
We're all dying.
Do it. Do it. My dear, would you be so kind?
No.
Sonia. Sonia. Don't leave me.
Sonia. Don't leave me. Alive. Sonia!
Culprit nor victim, the quick or the dead, neither time nor eternity. I am the wall, the desire for peace, for silence, for rest. I am nothingness. I leave you nothing.